But where would he be when he's released on earth? In a day which would be like a year. And then this creature spoke and said, I am Jassasa. Jassasa. Spy. So this is an island with a lot of people who excel in spying.
The 11th century Europe was ruled by the church, which held a firm grip on the hearts and minds of the people. This power enabled Pope Urban II to wage war on the Muslim Caliphate and crusade in what he called a War of the Cross to recapture the land of Jerusalem. It had been under Muslim rule since the year 637, but in 1099 this rule was brought to a bloody and sudden end. In the name of the cross, women were raped and murdered. Children were put to the sword, and it is said that blood ran in the streets knee-high to the horses. Out of this land of bloodshed and terror, a group of men arose. Men that would stop at nothing to get what they wanted, no matter what the cost. 20 years after Jerusalem was taken, the Dome of the Rock was seized by a group of warrior monks calling themselves the Knights of the Temple of Solomon, or more simply, the Knights Templars. In Jerusalem, the Templars began to deviate further and further away from the practices of Christianity. They learnt the secret arts of the Kabbalah, an ancient form of Jewish magic, along with its dark rites and rituals. The Jews had learnt the arts from the pagans of ancient Egypt during the times of enslavement to the Pharaoh and developed them into Babylon at the time of Nebuchadnezzar. In 1307, King Philip of France arrested them for charges of denial of Christ, homosexuality and idol worship, as well as magic. In 1314, Pope Clement V declared all Templars as heretics to Christianity, ordering all their properties to be seized. Their leader, Jacques de Morlaix, was captured and burnt to the stake. The Templars were cornered, and just when it seemed they were finished forever, a glimmer of hope arose from a seemingly certain end. They were to find a safe haven as well as an ally, but not in France. In fact, in a country in a desperate struggle for independence against the English, the country of Scotland. For some, Scotland's hope of independence had died with the death of William Wallace. However, to the King of Scotland, Robert the Bruce, the arrival of the Templars gave him a new secret weapon. Their experience, gained over 200 years of fighting the mighty armies of Islam, had made them expert in combat and warfare, and more than a match for any army brought before them. In 1314, the Templars, allied with Robert the Bruce and his army, took to the fields of Bannockburn in the long-awaited showdown with the English. Robert the Bruce's foresight paid off. The 25,000-strong English army suffered a humiliating defeat at the hands of only 6,500 men. The dream of an independent Scotland had finally been achieved. The Templars had brought themselves back from the brink of destruction, and never again would they allow themselves to be destroyed. This time, they would control the country by controlling its kings. And in order to preserve their secret order, the Templars would have to die. Or more precisely, the name would have to die. The Templars who had escaped Europe were finally laid to rest in Roslyn Chapel, Scotland, which stands to this day as sign of their presence in Britain. Their descendants became the true power of Scotland. In 1603, the death of Queen Elizabeth I left England without an heir to the throne. By virtue of descent, King James V of Scotland became King of England. In doing so, Scotland and England joined to form a new kingdom, and the power that the Templars held over Scotland spread to give them a firm grip on the whole of Great Britain. For over 100 years, the Templars concealed their activities, fading into the background until they were little known and little remembered. However, they did not cease to keep a firm grip on Britain. All the time they were planning, regrouping, and infiltrating positions of power in all corners of the kingdom. In 1717, the Templars made their reappearance in Europe. They had grown in both number and strength, and were now ready to coin a new identity, free from their reputation of the past, and given credibility by none other than the monarchy and aristocracy of England. And the name they chose for themselves was a name that would be known by many, but understood by a few. This new name, the Freemasons.
The answer, of course, is that when he's released on earth, he will be on that island. And from that island, he will launch his mission to liberate the Holy Land, to bring the Jews back to the Holy Land, to reclaim it as their own, to restore a state of Israel in the Holy Land, and get the Jews to believe that this is the Holy Israel of David and of Solomon, alayhi salam, and to cause that state of Israel to become the ruling state in the world. Which island is it? An amazing thing has happened. The British government did something which was incredibly strange and mysterious. A Briton, which is now the prince of the secular world, the secular world takes religion out of politics. And Britain is the prince of the secular world. Britain issues a declaration known as the Balfour Declaration. In November 1917, that it is the intention of His Majesty's government to work for the establishment of a Jewish national home in the Holy Land. Did you hear that? The only thing stranger than that that ever occurred in history was the day that the cow jumped over the moon. Why would a secular state, which leads the world of secular states, declare its intention to work for the establishment of a Jewish national home, meaning a Jewish state, in the Holy Land? 2 months later, this was October 1917, in December 1917, it is a British army led by General Allenby which defeats the Ottoman Islamic army and liberates the Holy Land. And when Allenby entered into Jerusalem, the British general declared, "Today the Crusades are over." Oh, but the Crusades were supposed to have been Christian wars. And you are now a secular state. You're not a Christian state, you're a secular state. How come a secular Britain is continuing a crusade started by the Pope 1,000 years before? That's strange. That is incredibly strange. Between 1918 and 1948, it is the island of Britain which ruled over the Holy Land on a mandate conferred by the League of Nations. And during that period of time, with tremendous deception, while pretending to keep the Jews out, Britain opened the door for the Jews of Europe to enter into the Holy Land. and to reclaim it as their own.